All right, Rotoviz Nation, welcome back to In Between the Lines. We're at episode number 11. So this week, we're gonna have a special hot minute. We're gonna have a special guest. And we also asked some seniors about New York. So guys, make yourself comfortable and enjoy this episode.
Welcome back to In Between the Lines, and today we have
Mrs. Eikenberry.
And people want have questions for you. They want you to answer. So, you ready for them?
I'm ready.
All right. First question: what's the highest you can sing?
Probably a C, about two octaves above middle C on a good day.
Yeah. Can you do it today? Good day. Can you do it right now?
I haven't really warmed up today, but we can try. All right. Let me give myself. I kind of doubt it. I've been like really lately. My piano takes a moment to turn on, so interesting stuff here.
We can. If...
All right. Close.
Right, there you go. Okay. Next question. Why do you like doing the musicals at school?
I just think it's a lot of fun to, be a different character, create these characters and to tell a story on the stage that way.
So what's next? What's the next musical? What would you like to do next?
Boy, I don't know. I've had lots of suggestions. Some people are saying Moana. Other people are saying something like Grease. Getting away from the Disney stuff and doing, something totally different. So I don't know. Usually in the summer I sit down and start kind of thinking about that, planning that out. So
actually six people asked for this one. It's how do you think the musical went this year?
I thought it went really well. I think we bumped it a week earlier than normal. I think we probably could have used that extra week just for all the little details and touches. We had a lot of kind of missed music cues, or the curtain didn't come at the right time, or someone missed their cue. Just a little more time to kind of clean things up, but I thought it went really well. I think it was a good show.
So out of the ones you've done, what's your favorite one?
My favorite has been Little Shop of Horrors. That was a while ago, maybe 2016 or 17. So I had a really good cast, and I just think it's a very funny show.
Who is the loudest choir kid you have in eighth grade?
In eighth grade, the loudest talker is probably Cooper Curtis. He's always talking across the choir to Jaina. But as far as singing, probably Gio, probably the loudest singer. Actually, he's a seventh grader though, isn't he? But he's in my junior high choir. So I'm sticking with Gio.
How many years have you taught at HN?
I think this is my 12th year. Yeah, I came in 2012, so yep, 12 years.
Somebody asked, like, who is the lowest baritone in the junior high choir?
Eli can go pretty low. I think Emmerine. Sorry.
Well, actually, this one's the final question. How do you feel about the choir that got every single one of them?
Junior high or high school?
Well, just either. Probably just both of them.
Okay. High school is very small this year. We only have seven, but they really work hard and, try. We have been combining with junior high because junior high is really very talented. We have about 21 and most of them, enjoy singing, aren't afraid to sing out. So sometimes we'll, at concerts, combine the two groups so we have more numbers, but both groups are good workers, good choirs.
Yeah, so that was all the questions. Thank you for answering those, and I'm sage and proud. Folks might understand you by and by. Just
move on up toward your destination. Welcome back, everybody. Good to see you again. Who am I here with?
Bianca Epling.
So some of you might know this, last week the seniors had their senior trip and that was in New York City. So I'm here with someone who was on the trip. So now we're gonna ask some questions. So I'm gonna start with, what was your favorite part of the trip?
My favorite part was going to the Broadway show.
So which show did you see?
We saw Michael Jackson.
And have you ever been to a Broadway show before, or was that the first time?
That was my first time.
And what would you rate your overall New York experience from 1 to 10? And are there big differences from living here?
I rate it like an 8. And the difference is it's like really, I don't know how to explain it.
Busy.
It's really busy here.
Would that be a town you might would live, or you would never live there?
I would never live there.
All right, and would you ever go back to New York?
Yes.
All right, thumbs up, and stay Asian Brown. Here with?
Ron Fraser.
So he is another senior, and so how would you rate your overall New York experience?
7 out of 10.
7 out of 10, that's not bad. And do you have one favorite experience?
Getting stuck in the elevator was very fun.
So tell me, how did that happen?
Well, they said they could fit one more in, and when I was walking in, I think like 6 other people walked behind me. And so there's like 16 people in the elevator, and we were stuck there for an hour.
Oh, guys, come on. Listen to the rules, okay? But it's a funny story to tell. So would you consider ever living in New York, or would that not be nothing?
No, because the inflation is high and too many tweakers.
All right, and what was your favorite site you saw, like Statue of Liberty, Memorial, or just Times Square? Was there one?
I think it was Times Square.
All right, thank you. That was Ron Fraser. Hey, everybody. So from what we hear, it was a great success. So we want to have a shout out to Mrs. Kano and Mr. Kano for taking care of all the seniors, making sure everybody's safe. And of course, to organize all that. Sure to say thank you. And yes, here we all had a great trip to the Big Apple. So here we'll show you some more pictures, and hope you guys like it.
These little town blues. It's up to you, New York, New York, New York. Take nothing less than the supreme best. Do not obey.
Welcome back to the Hot Minute. I'm here with
Sophia Faber.
What grade are you in?
6th.
Okay. Are you ready?
Yep.
3, 2, 1, go.
Favorite animal?
Pig.
Best day of the week?
I like Fridays because we get out early.
Favorite month?
July because it's my birthday.
Favorite HN experience?
Being in the plays.
Favorite sports season?
Volleyball.
One goal before you graduate? Talker or thinker? Best grit house?
Odin.
Best place to eat?
Chick-fil-A.
Which sports has the best student section?
Time.
Hope you guys liked the video. Come back and watch the next one, and hope you guys have fun with spring sports.